set to bring you baseball from one of the crown jewels of the sport, venerable Wrigley Field in Chicago. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the Chicago White Sox and the Chicago Cubs.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Chicago.
Stay tuned for Cubs baseball next. And the next to bat will be Tim Anderson. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. A shot to second base and handled for the first out. Up next for Chicago, Cesar Hernandez.
The second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. And he'll be rung up here by Clyde Washington. Strike three at the knees, and there are two away.
The first baseman,
now at the plate, Jose Abreu. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. 2-1 the count to the White Sox first baseman.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. In now is Nico Hoerner. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 home. Count still at 1-2. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out. So in now for Chicago, number 62. He readies for his first plate appearance. The 1-2 pitch. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down. Next, it'll be Matt Duffy trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. 1-1, here it comes. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder giving chase. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. Now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. And the count will be full.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off him.
Center fielder giving chase. He's there and records the first down. Next to hit, Eloy Jimenez. Oh, forget about this one. Bob Bob Bowie into the bleachers and gone.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
To the plate now, Gavin Sheets. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2. Swing and a line drive. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. Into the box, Brian Goodwin. And there's a base hit on the line.
having it.
So now to the plate, Zach Collins lifted down the line in left. And it's a foul ball. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four. Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the White Sox, Carlos Rodon. He could really open this lead up early if he can deliver here with the bases loaded. Here comes the 1-2. And another foul ball. Here's another 1-2. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Duffy onto the grass. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. So it's back to the top of the order now. And up next, it'll be Tim Anderson. Now this is on the ground to second. Is he going to get out of this? He is. They get the force at second base, and the inning is over. Now to the plate. Here is Patrick Wisdom. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. And that finds its way through for a base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
That is good. The first baseman.
At the plate, number 18. Popped him up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Trying here to plate the tying run from second. 3-2 pitch. Full count still. He'll try it again, 3-2. Swing and a liner. And that's in there. Base hit. Now a long throw to third.
That is it. The white field.
Stepping in now, Jason Hayward. Inside with the fastball, and he works the base on balls. So it's bases loaded, one away, and the pitcher Kyle Hendricks will be the next to bat. Cubs pitcher at the plate trailing with a 1-2 count. High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Goodwin. Makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. And he will score as that run breaks the tie and makes this a 2-1 ball game. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Nico Hoerner. Twos all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Here's the 1-1. Hit weakly on the ground to short. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag. So next to hit is number 62. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. 1-1. Here it is. Count is 1-2 now.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been as they'll strand the bases loaded. The side is retired. New inning set to get underway, and standing in as the switch hitting second baseman, Cesar Hernandez. A 1-1. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. Ready now for the White Sox, Jose Abreu. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball 4. Now a chopper to first, might only get one. Scooped up to second for one. Onto the pitcher covering it first, and it's your textbook 3-6-1 double play that'll get him out of the inning. Bottom of the third now, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Matt Duffy. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Patrick Wisdom. He scored after reaching on a walk in his first at bat. Drives it out to deep right center field. On the run is Goodwin. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Next to hit is Wilson Contreras. He singled first time up.
Contreras.
The 2-1 home is taken, ball 3.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Now it'll be number 18, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Hard on the ground towards short. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it the side is retired. All set for the start of the fourth, and up next the exciting Eloy Jimenez.
And that was a great swing he put on that changeup last time up to hit that home run. Just an absolutely textbook job of letting it travel, keeping his hands back before exploding on it.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
So the next to bat will be Gavin Sheets. He collected a base hit his first time up. Hit sharply on the ground. And that's the second out. And now here is Brian Goodwin. He singled in his first AB. Hit weakly back to the mound. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next it'll be the outfielder, Ian Happ. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So one away here in the Chicago fourth. Right, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. Counts even to Hayward, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. Love to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now.
Kyle.
And now the Cubs pitcher, Kyle Hendricks. He hit a sac fly earlier. The 1-1 waves and misses for strike number 2.
Hey, this guy obviously feels he can move traffic right here. He's taking 2 big swings. He's trying to help himself.
And he struck him out, his 7th of the ball game, and that ends the inning. And now in the box, Zach Collins worked a walk his first time up. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Fouled away. Another full count pitch home. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. The throw down to first, one away. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Carlos Rodon. He's 0 for 1 thus far. 1-1. Swing and a liner. And that's a base hit. 1 for 2 in his first couple of plate appearances. In now, Tim Anderson. 2-1 count to the Pale Hose leadoff hitter. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. One there, but one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue. Into the box, Cesar Hernandez. He bounced out last time up. All even now, 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. The 2-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Nico Hoerner, 0 for 2 on his line thus far. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1.
That's the ball. 2-1.
Well, that's ball three, and the Cubs right now, they're looking for base runners. Hey, they'd love to get a leadoff walk.
And this will be nowhere close as his control deserts him here. It's a 5-pitch walk.
Now batting.
So next to bat will be number 62. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first 2 plate appearances so far. Swing and a liner. Leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done. The next Cub up, Matt Duffy. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Hoerner stands at first with one out. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Right fielder giving chase. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So here's the cleanup hitter. Patrick Wisdom comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Now a move over to first and a dive, but he's back in there. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. That's a strike to throw down. Not in time. He's in there at second. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And he struck him out, his 8th punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So now here is Jose Abreu. He'll lead things off in the Pale Hose half of the 6th. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big
a swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. And it's gone. To the plate now, Yoan Moncada. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first, he's digging for second. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out. At the plate now, Eloy Jimenez. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Another 2-2 offering.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
And that'll get by and on through towards the wall. He's in at second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. Trevor McGill now takes back over on the mound here with nobody out in the sixth inning. So now to the plate, Gavin Sheets lifted down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 2-2. This is line to left. That's in there. Base hit.
Jimenez
rounds the corner and is headed home. And he's safe at the plate. And they now lead by two.
Now batting, the center fielder, Brian Goodwin.
Into the box now, Brian Goodwin, and it's fouled away. Three runs already home here. In the air, out to right. Hayward has a read on it, one out. And stepping in, Zach Collins struck out in his last trip to the plate. The 1-1. Four runs, eight hits, one error thus far for the White Sox. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. So here now is the pitcher, Carlos Rodon, a fly out and a single for him so far. Bottom part of the zone, a good changeup gets the call. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Wilson Contreras.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
2-2 to the Cubs catcher.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
Full count now. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Now batting.
Stepping in once again is number 18. 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. And he's way off balance with the swing there.
You see there, the pitch count is up to 88. And at this point in the game, that's a good place to be. So I think we'll see him stay out there for at least a little while longer.
So he backs up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Number 18 becomes out number 2 this inning. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball game, and this one ends the inning. Seventh inning ready to roll, and stepping up as the shortstop, Tim Anderson. To 1-2 now.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Stepping in next, Cesar Hernandez, grounded out in his last at bat. Here now the 2-2. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. The 1-1 home. Fouled off wide at first, but boy, that had some zip on it.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
Popped him up. Wisdom is right there. And he will put it away to retire the side.
Please join us for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Garrett Crochet will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh. Last half of the seventh here, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Jason Hayward. The 3-1. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center, but this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one. Robinson Chirinos will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2. Into the corner and slicing foul. Two runs on two hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Stepping forward, Nico Horner. No hits to this point. Fouled off. Here comes the 1-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Here it comes. This one's flared off to the right side. In there, a base hit. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the two-out base hit. Craig Kimbrel takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning. At the plate, number 62, and a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Throw over to the bag, and a dive, but he's back in. Working for the punch out, and the offering lifted down the line in left. And foul. Another try at 2-2. Grounded weakly down the line toward third. And this is going to work out for him. It's an infield single to make it first and second now.
The batter, number five, shortstop, Matt Duffy.
Stepping in now, Matt Duffy. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Cubs shortstop with a 3-1 count.
3-1 here, you have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
Inside, he misses ball four. So stepping in is Patrick Wisdom. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. the set and the 1-1 seared down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself. And a great job of pitching out of the bases loaded situation as the side is retired. Rex Brothers has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Into center field, line drive, base hit. Into the box, Eloy Jimenez. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. Next, here is Gavin Sheets. Singled home a run in his last time up. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. And he fouls this one off. And he is safe at second base as the decision to move up pays off, and that'll likely be scored a wild pitch. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Corner onto the grass. He can't get to it. This one's down.
The batter, the center fielder, Brian Goodwin.
In now, Brian Goodwin. 1-2 as he chases the slider.
You chase a pitch that bad outside the zone, you got to find a way to regroup, adjust the batting gloves. Only look over the heart of those 17 inches.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Next, it'll be Zach Collins. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. One and two to the White Sox catcher.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
To two balls and two strikes now.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Aaron Bummer will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Billy Hamilton is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Fouled away. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. So now into the box is number 18. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Now the 2-1 pitch.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder is on the run. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Now with the plate is Ian Happ. Only four outs remaining for them to try and rally back in this one. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. And this one misses high for ball four, and they have themselves a two-out base runner.
Up next for the Cubs.
So that'll bring up Jason Hayward. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, pretty unlucky right there, Matty.
But we'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. Jason Adam enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set for the start of the inning, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Billy Hamilton. The 1-1. Misses down below the knees. check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Here now the 2-2 is looked at, and the count moves full.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order's coming up right behind him.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first out. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Tim Anderson. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. And it's two balls and a strike for Tim Anderson. One out, nobody on. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
Borderline pitch right there. But as a low ball hitter, you can live with that as long as the umpire doesn't give him north as well.
Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon. So now to the plate, Cesar Hernandez. Two balls and a strike to Cesar Hernandez. Here's a look over to first, and he'll dive back in safely. Anderson leads off first with one away. And that one yanked just foul. Here now the 2-2. Is laid off and the count runs full.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
And it's fouled away. Runner at first here, one man out. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. There's one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. And they're runners at the corners now. Here it comes on 1-1. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus on making some good pitches.
Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one, and it's gone into the bleachers.
Yeah, he is kicking himself right now. He worked his tail off to get out of that jam and was one strike away from getting there. And then, boom, all that work goes to waste. From zero damage to a three-run homer in the blink of an eye.
Cody Hoyer takes over now with two gone here in the top of inning number nine. Standing in now, Eloy Jimenez. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And foul. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today.
Well, the left fielder's on it, and that retires the side. Now to the plate, number 66. First trip to the plate for him in the ballgame. Ready with the 1-1.
2-1.
Skied into straightaway right. Sheets is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. one away. And now, Nico Hoerner singled in his last at-bat.
Nico Hoerner.
And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
62.
Two out, nobody on. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. The Cubs are down to their final strike here. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Close, but it's not over yet. That's ball two.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
I went to the slider to try and get him to chase, but it's full now, 3-2. Hit softly on the ground to first. And he'll step on first for the out, and the ball game is over.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
7-2, the final score this afternoon. The White Sox rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Carlos Rodon pitches well enough to get the W. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious White Sox, 7 runs on 12 hits. One error, they left 8 runners on base.